meeting prosthetist Dr. Kevin Carroll and Mr. Dan Strzempka from the Hanger Clinic was really special for Jake and I. They made the tail for Winter the Dolphin. Yes, that Winter. The one from my all-time favorite movie, Dolphin Tale. Winter was just a baby when she was found tangled in a crab trap line. She was rescued and brought to the Clearwater Marine Aquarium, where she still lives today. Because of her injuries, Winter lost her tail.
I heard about Winter on the news that this little baby dolphin had just lost her tail, and I was thinking to myself, you know, we put prosthetics on people, why not a tail on a dolphin? I picked up the phone and I called my colleague Dan.
And I thought, Kevin lost his mind. I thought he went crazy. I'm like, this is it. But now right away we thought this would be the right thing to do. I mean, grew up in Florida, ever seen a dolphin, you're not going to fall in love with her.
So this is one of the many tails for Winter? Or like, do you switch them out or do you make them one at a time?
We make lots of tails. Dan, last time I was down with Dan, I left at about 6 o'clock in the evening. I was carving on the tail.
Exactly how many tails is a lot?
He calls me at 20.
I mean, we lost count. She's actually worn about 13 different types of designs, but in those types, we've tried many different things in the manufacturing process. We ended up with about way over 50.
Wow.
We put a new tail on about 3 weeks ago. And we did that because the last tail she had, she didn't outgrow it. She has actually start wearing it out. You know, this material would wear out because we have to make it flexible.
So what's that?
What's this? This is Winter's gel right here. And it stretches. Oh. Hold it.
Hold it. Hold that side. Hold tight.
See how it stretches?
Don't let go.
See how it stretches?
Whoa.
Wow, don't let it go. Whoa, don't let it go. Don't let it go. Whoa. Incredible stuff, right?
Yeah. So this fits in right with the tail?
It sure does. It sure does. Absolutely goes in there like that. And up over Winter's body. Keeps her protected.
So this would be on her body. We roll it on just like a sock?
Do you use the Winter's gel on human prosthetics?
Absolutely. And guess what? Before we put it on Winter, we had to test it. We tested it on a guinea pig. Guess who the guinea pig was?
Mr. Dan lost his leg after a lawnmower accident that happened when he was just a little kid. Wearing Winter's gel really helped to make his prosthetic feel more comfortable, so they tried it out on Winter's tail.
So how does this leg work? Is it like electronic or?
Yeah, sure is. And there's actually a computer in here, the hydraulic unit, but actually right here is where I plug it in every night. There's a battery,
so
I have to charge it every 2 days. This is where I plug a laptop in to program it. You know, when we first fit people with them, we watch them walk and we're getting a bunch of readings on the computer so we can change things to make them walk better.
Was she a stubborn dolphin or was she a
No, not at all. She's a great, very easy going. If all of our patients was like Winter, life would be very easy.
Yes.
Dr. Carroll and Mr. Dan had to study a lot of science, math, and engineering to become prosthetic specialists. They've helped a lot of other animals besides Winter, including tiny birds. And of course they fit in many children and grown-ups with artificial limbs. They've even taken some of them to meet Winter. I hope I'll get to visit Winter at the Clearwater Aquarium one day.